Hi everybody, and welcome to our recap of ABC of Vernacular Jazz. And this week is the squat Charleston. Now that's quite an energetic move, so I really recommend a little warm-up before you actually start doing this. So now, the components of the squat Charleston, we had the squat, boom. The weight is on the ball of the foot, the hips are down, but the chest is up, so don't be hunched over, yeah? We started practicing on 1-2, but in the routine, we're gonna do it on 7-8 in the music. So we're at 5-6-7-8. So we started with a squat, 7-8. And then we kicked right leg, left leg, right and out. Let me turn around. So I'm just gonna do it without the bounce. So we squat, I shift the weight onto my left foot, I swing my right leg up. I throw it down, I swing over to my right, and I swing the left foot up. And then I throw it down, and I swing the right foot up, and I bounce and hit back into the squat. And that bounce is gonna be two bounces. 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2. Notice my head isn't bopping up and down. So from here, we're gonna go squat, 7-8. 1-2, 3-4, 5-6-7. We added some arms. I'll turn around so you can see. We went to the left, to the right, cross and out. To the left, to the right, across and out. So we added that, oh, let me get one's facing you. We went, hit the squat. To the left, to the right, cross and out. To the left, to the right, across and out. Let's put it together. We go. 7-8, 1-2, 3-4, 5-6-7, 2-2, 3-4, 5-6-7, 3-2, 3-4, 5-6-7, 4-2, 3-4, 5-6-7. We added a Charleston, it's a step and a tap. Went back on the right foot on 1, 1-2, 3-4, 5-6-7, 2-2, 3-4, 5, let me turn around, 3-2, 3-4, 5-6-7, 4-2, 3-4, 5-6, back into the squat, boom. We did four Charleston, four squats, four Charleston, and then we did the squat Charleston turning over our left. So direction 1, 2, 3, 4. So I went, squat, a right, a left, turn and out, a right, a left, a turn and out, a right, a left, a turn and out, a right, a left, a turn and out. That was our four Charleston turning. Let's put it all together with music. I'll do it once facing you and once facing away. 5-6-7, step, touch. Fantastic. Welcome, welcome, welcome. So it's our ABC of jazz. And today we're going to look at the squat Charleston. Now it is quite an energetic move, but I can show you a version that's not so energetic, depending on how you're feeling and also the space around you. But the first thing I want you to do is just flap your arms, warm up the arms a little bit. Just flap them, because we're going to need to use them later. And then we'll just take them across and open. And each time I'm alternating which arm goes on top. And then I want you to pick one heel up like you're trying to kick your butt. Pick one heel up behind you.
Kick your what?
Kick your butt. It's a technical term. Now, I could do it like this, where my knee goes forward and I'm not really getting much of a stretch. So make sure you actually try and push the thigh back a little bit so you get actually a stretch in the thigh. So push the thigh back as you try to kick your butt. Feet nice and wide. One and two and three and four and five and six. And then combine it with those arms. One, two, three. How are we doing? Four.
Yeah, good.
Five.
Glenstonias.
Six. A seven. Eight. Cool. Then, keeping the arms very straight, lift one arm up and push the other one back and take three little bounces. One, two, three. Reverse. One, two, three. One, two, three. Keeping the arms as straight as you can. One, two, three. Oh, one, two, three, or one, two, three, or one, two, three. This singles. One, 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 one. Good. Bring the hands slightly in front of you and just slice them in a big circle. And slice. And slice. And slice. And slice. And slice. And slice. And lastly, we're just going to march, and you're going to pick the leg up at least at 90 degrees, or just slightly higher, but facing 90 degrees, and one, and think hands go ear to cheek, ear to cheek. Just move the hands as well. Just going to get a little bit of movement going. Okay. My show, have we got the first song?
We do. Here we go. I wish you could shimmy like my sister Kate.
Okay, let's shimmy. And just take a nice soft bounce. Shake the arms. So on the toes, take a bounce. Let the shoulders come up and down. Shoulders nice and loose. One more time, shoulders nice and loose. Now, hands in the air, push. And down. And up. Twist. Keep twisting. See that little exercise we did before? One arm crossing and then the other arm. And just march. Cheek to cheek. Okay, feet nice and wide. Shimmy the shoulders. Over on one leg, drop down. Other side, tap the toe. Down,
this is shimmy.
And tap. Down, and tap. Down, 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 tap. Bend the toes out. Just let the hands go nice and relaxed. So swing them around, pushing from the hips, but keeping the feet very strong and braced on the floor.
Soften the knees, don't lock the knees.
Soften the knees. Yeah. And then you can let one toe go. Just let one heel come off the floor. Arms nice and relaxed. Up, push it back. Other side, up and down, up and down, up and down, up and down. Okay, we're going to get straight into the step because I know it's going to, it's quite a tricky one. So the first thing we're going to do is we're actually going to take a squat on 7-8. We're going to drop and jump up. So we're going to squat on 7-8 bumps. For now it can be 1-2, but when we do it with music, we 7-8. So go 5-6-7 and squat and up. So it'll be 1, so 5-6-7-8. Squat, 2-3-4-5-6-7-8. 1-2-3-4-5-6-7, stop. When I squat, I'm really going to be nicely balanced over 2 feet. Butt down, but chest up. So I want to be nice and tall in the top. I want to lift up from the waist up and the arms out, but at the same time, I want to push the hips back as I squat. If you want an easier version, you can always just go right, left. If you don't want to jump into it, yeah, you can just go right, left. So just try that one. So we go 5-6-7-8-1-2. But ideally, we're going to go 1-2-3-4-5-6-7.
On 7-8?
Yeah, we're doing 7-8 with the music, but for now it's easier to count on 1-2. Okay, okay. Can we just have one song? We can still do this on 1-2 for now. Just to get us into it. 5-6, here we go. Squat. 5-6-7-1. 5-6-7, 5-6-7, 5-6-7, freeze, and have music. How are we doing?
Yeah, good.
Cool.
We all got that. Just stylistically, we've got a lot of of bear pause.
Ah, okay.
So we'll be strong hands, so, more like fingers
together. I'm not totally close together, yeah. But they're fairly close, they're not spread, yeah. Yeah, that would be a bit weird. That's a bit scary.
Yeah, we've got a few, few poles going.
There's a lovely picture you've probably seen of like Frankie Manning. He's in this sort of squat Charleston position.
It's not in this room, is it?
No, that was not. Okay, next thing we're going to do is we're going to swing the legs behind us. You know, like we did that warm-up exercise of trying to kick our butt? So we're going to think right, a left, a right. I'll just turn around. A right, a left, a right, a left. We go right. A left, a right, a left, and right, a left, a right, and left.
Good. Just to make sure that you're actually crossing a little bit in at the back when you pick up the leg.
Let me do it facing you once. So from here, I'm going to go right, yeah. Left, so right, left, right, left. So I'm having to switch weight onto one foot, onto the other foot, onto one foot and the other foot.
So that's much better.
Actually, the squat's going to be on 7-8. We're going to go 1-2-3-4-5-6-7, hold 8. However, that is the easy version. So if you're not feeling very energetic, you've got bad knees, you've got the wrong floor, the wrong shoes, that's absolutely fine. Take it easy. But if you can, we want to make it a little bit more bouncy. Let me do it once facing you. You can just watch for a second. So I'm going to squat on 7-8, and then I'm going to think heel and toe. 1-2-3-4-5-6-7. 1-2-3-4-5-6-7. 1-2-3-4-5-6-7. But again, if you want to go 7-8, 1-2-3-4-5-6-7, you can. So you've got an option. Okay, let's just go into the squat.
Seven.
We're just going to repeat these kicks. You'll notice I'm bouncing on the supporting foot. In fact, actually, let's just do that once.
Yeah.
Bounce, 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 change, bounce, 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 change, bounce, 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 change, bounce, 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 change.
Can you do two bounces on each side only?
Yeah, bounce, two bounces on each side. Bounce. Also try and observe my head's not going up and down more than I have to. So my bounce is into the floor. Yes, I'm up, I'm lifted, I've expanded, but I'm not going up through the feet. So if I show you what I mean, one, two, one, two, one, two, one, two, one, two, one, two. So my head stays here, it's not going. That would be quite tiring. Okay, does that make sense?
I think so.
We'll do it without the crossing, just one, two, one, two. So we go step, bounce, step, bounce, step, bounce, step, bounce. One, two, one, two. One, two,
so
one,
cardio
two,
for
one,
the week.
Two, one, two. This is the cardio move, the squat Charleston. It's going to look like this. We are going to hit 7-8 now with the music. 7-8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So if I do it in slow motion for you once. 7-8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I sort of hold. 7-8. So essentially I'm going single, single, hold, out. Single, single, hold, squat. Single, single, hold, squat.
Good.
Right.
Can we do the squat on 7-8 and the side to side without too much bounce? Just
okay.
To get the rhythm.
Without the bounce. Yeah, we'll do it without the bounce.
So, 7-8. Do you want to count everyone in? So we can do that all,
so,
not too
together.
Fast.
5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Good. Can we add the kicks?
Yep.
Like
with
the
kicks.
In, out. Yeah.
So
but
the whole,
still
the
no
whole
bounce.
Thing.
With no bounce, but same
with
thing
no
with the kicks.
Okay. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It's hard not to bounce.
It's hard.
It's easy.
That's
it's easier to bounce.
That's good. You'll see how the bounce comes
the bounce
off of
makes,
its own accord.
Yeah, it makes the movement.
Okay. Take
with
a little,
the bounce.
Little breath.
Do you want to count us in?
A 5, 6, 7.
No. 5. A 6. A 5, 6, 7, 8.
3, 4, 5 and drop. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and drop. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and drop.
Single,
1, 2,
single,
3, 4, 5,
hold and drop.
Face.
Single, single, double bounce, drop. How are we doing?
Good. There's a little bit of going, dropping side to side.
Okay, so here's a good lesson, yeah? Feet wider than shoulder width. If I want to stand on one leg, I have to shift my body weight over that leg so I can balance, and I want to be braced on that leg nice and strong, and my weight's pressing into the ball of the foot, but my body, the head through the hip, should be in line with the ball of the foot. If I'm here, I'm actually out of balance and I'm probably going to fall over at some point. Yeah, it doesn't feel very balanced. Likewise, let's try the other side. So shift the weight onto this side, shift the weight, try to think the knee's bent, your balance runs through here, through the leg, however, the top of the body is expanded and breathing, the bottom half of the body is down, rooted into the floor. So avoid this. Yeah, you want to be up with the chest, down with the body.
That's better, yeah. For those, that's better for everybody. Oops, sorry.
It's a plane going overhead. We've got the windows open, sorry.
Yeah, it's much better for everybody. The hips could be a little bit more level, so at the moment they're still tipped over a bit.
Oh, you mean like this?
Yes, a little bit. Yeah.
Ah, okay.
So
I'm sort
it's
of...
It's the same idea, but...
It's a falling feeling, and although I'm sort of balanced, I'm not very secure, I'm not very braced on that leg. So here, I'm shifting. I shift my weight over to one side. I shift my weight over to the other side. So my hips move across and across. So I've got that skating feeling.
Yeah, that's nice, Helen.
Skate, 2, 3, 4. Skate. So it's that skating feeling of the single
steps.
Yeah,
that clicked for some of you.
Let's do 4 squat Charleston. Ready? Squat 7, 8 with bounce.
A 5, a 6, a 5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, drop. A 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, drop. A 3, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. A 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Good, we got the elements separately. Putting them together is a little bit tricky. So we've lost the side to side a little bit, and the kicks are...
Okay. Let's call it out. Let's do it one more time. Can I do it facing or should I do it away?
Maybe away. Okay. It's easier to see the sides.
Are you ready one more time? Here we go.
We do it one slow motion?
As slow as is possible. It's not so easy slow, but we'll try slow.
5, 6, 5, 6, 7, and
left foot,
kick,
right foot,
kick,
left and drop.
Left kick, right kick, left and drop. Left kick, right kick, left and drop. Left kick, right kick, left and freeze.
Have we got
that was
the
better.
Bounce?
I was looking more at the sort of shape, which was much, much better. Now we could add some bounce.
I think the bounce helps, and the bounce goes down into the floor. Down, 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 down. What I mean by down into the floor, this would be up. Can you see my head is going up? Whereas here, the bounce is all happening from below the waist. Yes, my body is expanded because that makes me lighter, but the bounce goes into the floor. That's the African American roots, the African roots, I should say. Okay, should we try once with music?
Sure. Let's see, that's.
It's quite fast.
Yeah, it's quite fast.
And the fast one.
Sorry?
Okay. Whilst Anna is finding some slow music, I'm going to show you something about the arms. So you can rest the legs for a minute. Frog. Arms out. Then you're going to swing. I'll do it the same way as you so we get the same direction. You're going to swing the same direction as the leg that you're kicking. And swing. And then you're going to cross and out. So I'm going out, I go to my left. So notice that my leg would go in that direction, my arms go in that direction. So out, so go to your left. So I'm going to my left, which is opposite to you. Left, right, cross and out.
I've got
so again, frog. 1, 2, cross and out. 1, 2, cross and out. So out, 1, 2, across and out. 1, 2, across and out. And I'm thinking swing from the shoulders. Shoulders, shoulders, cross and bounce. Shoulders, shoulders, cross and pop. How are we doing with the arms?
Good. So some of you, it's sort of lifting the whole body, even the hips. It should be just the arms.
Okay. Everyone stand up straight. Swing the arms. You have to put them in front of you. It's hard. Now get down. Now you can swing the arms. They're not freer to move. So yeah, you want to think nice, loose arms. And I'm swinging from the shoulders.
Yeah,
1, 2, across and out. 1, 2. Across and out.
Do you want to do that, turn around so that we get the right...
In slow motion with the footwork. Bounce. 1, 2, 3, 4. Cross and out. 1, 2, 3, 4. Cross and out. 1, 2, 3, 4. Cross just the arms. Left, right, cross and drop, left,
nice,
right, cross and squat.
We've got formation team.
Excellent. Woo!
Excellent. Do you want some music?
Okay, music, the whole thing with the bounce. Squat Charleston. Right, let's have a break from that.
Yeah.
Starts with the right foot. We're going to go step, touch. Think back on the right, touch the left, forward on the left, touch the right. Tap, step, a tap. We go step, and tap. Back on the right,
tap.
Forward step. On the left.
Step.
Back on the right, forward step. On the left. So we're going to
difference
start.
Between a step and a tap, Simon.
A step is a weight change. Everybody take one step, pick up the other foot. A tap, you're staying on the same leg and tapping. So you can do lots of taps, but you can only do one weight change at a time. Weight change is a step, tap. So we're gonna think step, tap, step, tap, step, tap, step, tap. And of course it's gonna be our Charleston. So you're going to think step, tap, step, tap, step, tap, step, tap. Just a little side note. If I was dancing this with a partner, leaders would generally start forward or backwards on the left foot. I'd go step, touch, which means the follow would be going backwards on the right. Step, touch. So that means we're just picked one side and we're going to do the follow. So we're going to step back on the right foot. We're going to go step, touch. Swing the arms.
Charleston, baby.
Tap from the side. Step. It's the Lindy Charleston. Step. Boom. And freeze. So I'm braced on my right leg. I'm supporting my weight. I've lifted up here. I'm not hunched over. Lift up here.
Yeah, looks good.
All the weight's free to move because you're nicely balanced on the ball of the foot, correct?
For all those that I can see, it's perfect.
Good. So we go step back, tap back, step forward. Same thing, I'm transferring the weight. So I'm striking out with my left foot and I'm bringing my weight over the top and then I can tap or kick, whatever. So step, touch, step, touch. Step, touch. Are we all swinging the arms?
Yeah, we are now.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 3, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. How's the posture? 5, 6, 7.
Yeah, pretty good. I think for some, the coordination of arms and legs is causing trouble. I suspect it's because you're thinking about it.
Don't think about it too much. It's just like walking. When you walk down the road...
Well, that's how you walk down the road, Simon.
With that swagger. Okay, so as we step back on our right foot, I'm going to swing my right arm forward. As I tap back on my left toe, I reverse the arms. I step forward on my left foot, the right arm comes forward, obviously the left goes back, and then I tap forward on my right and I reverse the arms. So the arms are essentially going right, left, right, left. You go right, left, swing the arms, right, left. You know in the warm-up exercise when we did this, yeah, I said ear to cheek, it's the same feeling. Yeah, it's the same feeling. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Okay, yeah, well, I think we're all there. Well done.
Okay, so let's do 4 Charleston and 4 squat Charleston and back into 4 Charleston and then 4 squat Charleston. Uh-huh.
5, 6, 5, 6, 7 and Charleston. Touch, step, touch. Number 2. 5, 6, 7. Number 3, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7 and 4.
2, 3, 4, 5 and drop. Squat. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
2, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 3, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 4, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yes,
from here
excellent.
We go back to the beginning. So you've got to push off your left foot. Push off the left foot and step, touch, step, touch. So although I've landed on 2 feet, I can very quickly anchor onto my left foot a little bit. So I push off the left foot and step back on the right. Okay,
I'm
music.
Looking good. Same music. Take a little bounce.
Okay, wait for the phrase.
A 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, right. Step back. 2, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 3, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. Get ready.
Here we go. Okay, one last thing. We want to do the squat Charleston turning. So we're gonna go squat, right, left, right and turn. Right, left, right and turn. So on that double bounce, on my left foot is when I'm gonna turn.
You're turning to your right shoulder?
Sorry?
Turning
over my left shoulder.
Oh, sorry, yes, I watched you in the mirror.
Yes, yeah, so I'm turning. So if this is front, 1, 2, 3, back to front. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Good.
We've here we go
directions.
With the turn. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Turn.
5 and turn. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Turn,
hop and
drop.
Turn.
Turn. Yeah, nice.
That's why the hopping helps, because actually it's easier to turn. Right, a quick sip of water, then we're going to try some music. We're going to do 4 Charleston, 4 squat Charleston front, 4 Charleston, 4 squat Charleston turning. And that will be today's lesson. Are you ready? Today was a bit of a workout, wasn't it? For a half hour, it was a good workout. Let's have a quick sip of water. On the top of that song. Yeah. Here we go.
Okay.
Turn around.
Touch. I'm not sure that's helpful. you've earned your glass of wine tonight.
So any comments, questions? Did it work? Thumbs up if it worked. Was that a new step for anyone? Was it a new step?
Yeah, for Glenn, Helen, John, I think.
Okay, who's done it before?
Emma.
Okay. Was it...
Elizabeth had done it.
Did you learn anything by doing it again? Was there any extra... What was the difference?
Well, you taught it to me before the other week, and I found it really helpful going through it slowly.
Yeah. It is hard going through slowly.
Well, but
hopefully
it's
better the second time.
It helps to break it down, yeah.
Yeah.
It's a tricky move, but it's good to, yeah, it's good to repeat it, it's good to do it slow. And if you ever like get stuck on it, you can think back of those different elements. Think of just what the feet are doing side to side, the bounce, the kicks, the arms, and often we can do all these elements as putting them together, which is where the practice comes in.
I'm going to leave you with one thought. When you learn any of these moves, you're thinking about where your body weight is. You're thinking about, is it over the toes? Are my knees soft? Have I transferred my weight? Can I bounce on one leg and keep my balance? Am I balanced, or am I, oops, out of balance? Is my head bopping up and down, or is my butt bounced down, but my body is up? So there's always lots of things to think about that you can gain. If you've done the move before, it gives you more chance to think about all these different elements, which is why it's really great to sometimes come back and review some of these things so that you can, like, even if you know the steps, sometimes a little review and you can just analyze, oh, maybe I took it easy there, maybe I need to make it bigger, maybe I have to move the arms bigger. Think of different ways. Right, I think well done, guys. Good job.